Content Companion is Latera's solution that allows us to quickly store and retrieve pieces and parts of documents or entire documents, right? This process that legal drafters go through today of identifying a document that was used at some point in the past on a matter relatively similar to what we're working on now, and either picking pieces and parts of that document to reuse or just leveraging the entire thing as a precedent and going through and replacing all the prior client-specific information and so on, right? That very mechanical and clunky process of either duping and revising or cutting and pasting pieces and parts of documents, that's what this is designed to help with. Now, when we think about the features and functions in here, our objectives are very straightforward. We want to give you an easy way to save content off, whether that's a piece of a document or whether that's an entire document. And we want to give you easy ways to insert that content in the future, right? Because when we think about the existing workflows, it's either if we're doing an entire document, a process of using find and replace to go through and get rid of all the content that we need to replace, or if we're doing pieces and parts of a document, there's this very mechanical process where we have to do the same thing. We have to get rid of the prior client information, but then we also have to do the cut and paste special and match all the destination formatting and all that jazz, right? So if we can help with those two workflows, that's our primary objective. Now, the first thing for me to mention from a technical perspective is that this lives in Microsoft Word, just like the rest of our Latera desktop tools. And currently, we're going to look at our Latera desktop ribbon, but during this video, we are going to focus on Content Companion or Clause Companion. And that is the content group within my Latera desktop ribbon here. Now, we are going to start by clicking the Show Library button. And that opens up my library over on the right-hand side, and we can quickly see a couple of headings. We can see My Clauses or My Stuff. We can see Firm Clauses or Firm Stuff. And we can see practice areas or shared stuff, right? In my case, my administrator has turned our shared folders into folders that are for specific practice areas that anyone in those practice can add or retrieve content from. But this is the basic structure, right? As we think about saving things off or reusing things, I can have my personal information, we can have firm curated information, and then we can have shared information either among groups of people or from individual to individual. And as we think about the core workflows here, right, how do we actually make this an easy solution to use? It comes down to two things: saving stuff off and inserting stuff into a document. The process of saving something into Clause Companion is super straightforward. Select the content we want to save, click the Save button, and then we can go through and do a couple of things. We can give this a name, we can add some guidance if we want to. We can decide where to save it. And then lastly, we have this important option down at the bottom to anonymize the content that we're saving. What this means is that we can read through whatever it is that we're saving and identify the things that we might not want to save, right? The client-specific information, the dates, company names, personal names, addresses, dollar amounts, all those types of things that we might not want to preserve as we save something off into our library. Now, I'm going to go ahead and hit OK, and this will allow me to save this piece of content. So, super simple to go through here and save a piece or a part of a document. Now, when we think about the second half of this workflow, right, if the first is saving things off, then the second half is inserting content into a document, and we want that to be super straightforward as well. So, when we think about the mechanical process of copy and paste, there's a couple of important things to remember, right? The first is that we have to cut out of a document that, may have other client information in it, and we just tackled how do we help with that. But then there's the, I have to paste special and format the paragraph, and sometimes it'll break the numbering, or I'll end up with repeated section headings or things like that. And there's all this just challenging logistical stuff when it comes to assembling a document of language that has come from different sources. And we can get rid of all of those just little annoying things about bringing content into a document. So in this case, we have a request for a deposit clause. I happen to have a deposit clause handy. I can just go ahead and select that and then drag and drop it to insert it into the document. I could also double-click if I wanted to. And then this brings that piece of content in and it matches the destination formatting. I didn't have to do anything special when I saved this or when I inserted this to get it to match the destination formatting here, right? It just did it for me. It automatically incremented it to 4.3. It applied the same style and the appropriate level of the numbering scheme. So I don't have to worry about trying to go through and do these things manually. Now, the other really important thing for me to mention is that you can leverage this technology using track changes or whatever process it is that you use for version control today. So let's go ahead and scroll down to the bottom here and let's start to add some additional content. You can see here we have a request for some context around term and termination. In this case, we could go through and insert things one by one if we wanted to, but let's go ahead and insert multiple pieces of content at once. So we'll go ahead and select both of these and just drag them in. And you'll notice that this gives me the ability to insert, not just one, but both pieces of content. And lastly, we can scroll down here and we can insert our disclaimer clause and just bring that in as well, right? So super simple to go through here and quickly add content to this document. So this process of saving, very straightforward. The process of inserting content into the document, very straightforward as well. Now, there's a couple of other important things for us to think about when it comes to making this content available to other people. Right, we've talked about the logistical challenges of copying and pasting or duping and revising a document that we've worked on before, but one of the things that this can also help with is the need for drafters to have access to good language that they know that they can use and trust. Right, I think a really great example of this is the first or second year associate who's in the process of kind of still ramping up and becoming knowledgeable about preferred language, both of the partners and colleagues that they work with and also of their clients, right? And as a result, oftentimes when I speak with partners, they'll spend a year and a half ramping new associates on preferred language. And one of the ways that I've seen people start to leverage this technology is through the idea of creating things like shared folders that are maybe specific to clients, right? So in this case, for example, I have a folder for Madison Financial. And you'll notice that if I want to do something like share this folder, I can right-click on it and I can click share, and then I can decide who I want to share this folder with. So that instead of, bringing someone up to speed gradually over a series of 7, 8, 12 months, right, I can quickly just share this content out to them and I can point them to this specific location as the approved place to go through and access this, right? And ultimately, what this means is twofold. First off, we give folks an easy way to access the content that is approved for them that they care about. But secondly, it's really simple to use this tool if we've just seen, right? Super simple to save, super simple to insert stuff. And because this is better than copy and paste, it means that people will actually use it, right? It's not me pointing someone to a Word document that lives on a shared drive that might be really hard for them to try to access and ultimately repurpose content from. It lives in Microsoft Word. It's really simple to just drag and drop content in. And as a result, there's a lot less friction to beginning to get up and running with this. All right, so the final thing that I want to mention here is this idea of, we've gone through, we've saved a specific part of a document, we've inserted a specific part of a document, but what if we wanted to do this with a whole document, right? The entire thing. Well, we can do that as well. We will quickly go through and say, for example, we have an NDA that we want to save. Well, we can go ahead and click our save button, and instead of selecting a specific paragraph or section, I can just click save with nothing selected, and that'll select the entire document. I can go through and capture the information that we talked about earlier. I can decide where to save it, and then again, we can leverage this anonymize button to go through and get rid of that prior client information so that I don't have to go through the dupe and revise workflow manually. Now, the other really important thing here is that I can decide what gets anonymized. So maybe I want to leave all of my clients' information, but I want to anonymize the other side of this NDA. And when I do anonymize the other side of this NDA, I want to replace the things that I get rid of with variables instead of static placeholders. What that means is that when I leverage this document in the future, I have a very simple to create template that we've just gone through and created. So with that said, let's go ahead and open up our NDA example here and just take a look at this one-sided NDA, right? So for example, here we can see it looks like seven different things that I need to quickly go through here and fill out. We can see that certain fields can even have dates or content pre-populated, and I can go through and start to fill this content out. Now, I'm not going to put everything in here, but let's go through and quickly put in, for example, the company name, right? So we'll go ahead and put in the name for ABC Company right here. You can see that it populates up at the top, but also everywhere that we saw the company name that we anonymized earlier, we've now put a variable that gets filled out when we write our company name, right? So we can see in the notices section, in that signature block, and also in the signing section down below, ABC Company has been inserted where that old company name was before. And again, this just gives us a really easy way to go through and quickly create these personalized templates. Now, again, there's a ton of additional functionality that we could talk about, but that's the core of it, right? Let's give people an easy way to go through and identify the content that they want to save it off, reinsert it, and ultimately share it if desired.